soil. What do you mean by this? They were crop sharers. Means they means they represent to landlord. They represent to landlord. They crop shares and not share the cost of output. Not share the cost of output. So I hope it is clear. They always remained interested. Means they means landlord. Landlord always remained interested to collect maximum land revenue. Maximum land revenue from the farmers. From the farmers, because you know that landlord means owner of the land, and means landlords means owner of the lands, and means always you can say landlords always try to, landlords always try to collect maximum land revenue. Land revenue means land revenue as a rent, land revenue as a rent, or you can say in form of rent from the farmers. So farmers became more poorer. Farmers became more poorer and were not unable to develop agriculture sector, because you know that, see, you know that landlords means they were not crop sharers. They were crop sharers and not share the cost of output. Means farmer, see, landlord always try to share crop. Means you can say try to share crop of production, but not share the cost of output. So farmer became more poorer and they were unable to develop agriculture sector. So I hope this question is clear. Means what was the characteristics or features of Indian agriculture on the eve of independence? First point, agriculture sector was subsistence occupation. Agriculture sector was a subsistence occupation on the eve of independence. Second point, level of productivity and production was extremely low in agriculture sector on the eve of independence. Third point, on the eve of independence agriculture sector was totally dependent on rainfall. It means dependency on rainfall. And fourth point is landlord tenant relation. Means on the eve of independence, landlord tenant relation was not good. So I hope all of you have understood this first question, or you can say what was the condition of Indian agriculture on the eve of independence. So please pause the video and note down this. See next question. Question number 2. Explain the reasons or causes responsible for decay. Decay means finish of Indian handicraft. Or you can say like this, what was the condition of India's handicraft industry on the eve of independence? On the eve of independence, see, what was the condition of Indian handicraft on the eve of independence? Or you can say like, explain the reasons or causes responsible for decay means finish of Indian handicraft. See, first of all, discriminatory tariff policy. Discriminatory means partiality. Discriminatory means partiality, and tariff means tax. Tariff means tax. See, under this policy means under discriminatory tariff policy, imports to India were made tariff free. Imports to India were made tariff free while heavy tariff were imposed. While heavy tariff were imposed on the export of Indian handicraft. On the export of Indian handicraft. It means that, see, what do you mean by this line? What do you mean by this line? See, it means that British goods were cheaper. British goods were cheaper and Indian goods were expensive. Means Indian goods were expensive and British goods were cheaper. According to this statement. According to this statement, see, imports to India were made tariff free. It means this line represents British goods, and while heavy tariff were imposed on the export of Indian handicraft, this line represents means Indian goods. See, as a consequence means, or you can say as a result of it, British goods begin to be sold in India, because you know that British goods were cheaper and Indian goods were expensive. So British goods begin to be sold in Indian market, and Indian handicraft products started losing their domestic as well as foreign market. So you can say like this, handicraft industries were going in loss situation. That's why means decay of Indian handicraft. That's why decay of Indian handicraft on the eve of independence. See, next point is competition. See, Indian handicraft could not face the increasing competition from British goods, which were cheaper and better quality compared than the handmade goods. So we can say like this, on behalf of this statement, it means British goods. You know that British goods were machine made goods and which were cheaper and better quality also. So we can say like this means British goods begin to be sold in Indian market, and Indian products means Indian handicraft products started losing their Indian market as well as foreign market. So I hope all of you have understood means decay of handicraft industry on the eve of independence. See, next point, change in demand pattern means as a result of foreign culture, you can say like as a result of foreign culture, a new class of people emerged in India who liked British goods than the Indian goods. This changed the pattern of demand against Indian product, or you can say like this, after this, that's why British goods to be sold in Indian market, and Indian products started losing their market. So I hope all of you have understood these three points, means which are reasons or causes for responsible for decay of Indian handicraft. So please pause the video and note down this. See, fourth part of this question, disappearance of princely courts. What do you mean by princely courts? You know that before the British rule, means Nawabs, Rajas and Emperors used to rule over in different parts of the country. Used to rule over in different parts of the country. All of you know that means before the British period, Rajas, Nawabs and Emperors used to rule over in different parts of the country. I hope this point is clear. They means Nawabs, Rajas, Emperors used to support the handicraft, used to support the handicraft, means these princely courts means nawabs, rajas and emperors came to an end with the beginning of British rule in India. This line is most important. These princely courts came to an end. See, first of all, before the British period, Nawab, Rajas and Emperors used to rule over in different parts of the country, and they used to support the handicraft. But after the beginning of British rule, princely courts came to an end with the beginning of British rule in India. So as a result, support to Indian handicraft also came to an end. By the end of princely courts. So I hope all of you have understood this last point of this question. So please pause the video and note down this.